Good afternoon, dear students, parents, and everyone who is interested in British Management University channel. So today we will have a guest lecture with the Director of Studies at the English Language Department of British Management University, Estella Eaton. Hello, Estella. How are you doing today?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm okay, thank you. So welcome, and thank you for agreeing to have an interview with us.
Well, my pleasure.
Ms. Eaton, you were born in Bloomington, Indiana, and now you are living in Uzbekistan. How do you find it overall?
Yeah, it's interesting. I mean, Bloomington, the first city that I moved to in Uzbekistan was about the same size as Bloomington, just a little bit bigger than Bloomington. So the first city I moved to was Urganch in Khwarezm, and Urganch is about 100,000 people. And Bloomington is just a little bit smaller than that. I think it's about 90,000, or it might be almost as big as Urganch now. So for me, it was really interesting because I hadn't lived in my hometown for a long time. I left Bloomington when I was 15. And then it took me until a couple years ago to move back to a city that size, you know, a smaller city, because I'd been living in big cities ever since. And it was nice. It was kind of like a homecoming in that way. So I had to get used to that slower pace and kind of get used to everybody knowing you and get used to that social atmosphere of a small town. But I did have a reference for that growing up in Bloomington, so it wasn't that difficult an adjustment. And the people are really nice. I mean, it's a really nice place to live, Urganch. So. It reminded me a lot of Bloomington.
As you lived in five countries, South Korea, North Macedonia, Czech Republic, and United Kingdom, and also Uzbekistan, what were the main differences you felt in education in each country?
You wouldn't think that these countries had that much in common, but they kind of do. So I found that, you know, Czech Republic and North Macedonia and Uzbekistan, that these are highly kind of they're intercultural societies, right? They've got a real intensity of culture and diversity within sort of small local communities, and there's just a lot of layers to people, you know? And of course, you know, the United States and the UK and South Korea, they're multicultural, but they're not quite as intercultural, right? So to me, it affects the education system, because you might have a student, for example, in your class whose father is Tatar, whose mother is Korean, and who grew up speaking Russian their whole life, living in Tashkent. And yet they feel themselves a citizen of Uzbekistan, and that's their identity. You know, coming from that environment, when I was teaching, you know, in these other countries, one big difference that I felt was that I think it felt more teacher-centric to me. Even in the UK, a little bit, it felt more teacher-centric, whereas in the United States, we have all these sort of liberal attitudes towards education that came out of that, you know, the sense that it should be learner-centric, it should be student-centered. And so for me, that was kind of an adjustment in all of the countries that I lived in. But yeah, and one thing that I find to be very true at BMU is that there's a real balance between being teacher-centered and being student-centered. And I think it's very healthy. So there's a lot of healthy respect for the teacher in the classroom. And there's a lot of trust that the teacher is going to, you know, kind of lead you in the right direction. And that, I think we've lost a lot of that in the United States. Anyway, it's a wonderful place to work. And I like that at BMU we haven't quite imposed one education system on the other. We sort of, you know, we take what works and we keep developing it in the way that that works best for everybody.
Can you please give more information about pre-foundation course to our future students, and what opportunities does it give to students?
So the pre-foundation course, it's a course that's designed for seniors in high school or in secondary school. And it's for students who are really not just committed to attending this university, but who are committed to the idea of attending an international university. So what we do is we give them this full experience. We give them access to the library. We give them access to BMU events. We encourage them to enjoy the campus. It's kind of a welcoming, you know. We want them to understand what university life is like so that, you know, they will easily bridge into that and not be shocked by it. Because a lot of first-year students, they have a hard time their first semester and even their second semester because they're just getting used to the idea of university. They're just getting used to what it means to have sort of university-style assignments. So it's kind of a mixture between a university preparatory course and an English course. And the students are great. I mean, they're really motivated. We gave them a project that was almost identical to one that we had in the foundation year. And they nailed it. They did a really great job with it. So, I'm really excited about the future of this program and, you know, the students that we're going to hopefully attract to the program.
How long have you been with BMU already, and how do you like it here?
Well, I really enjoy BMU as a workplace and a work culture. One thing that was very surprising to me was the kind of lack of toxicity and the lack of, well, I guess I'm just paraphrasing, but unhealthy competition, right? So there's a lot of camaraderie here at BMU among the faculty and the staff, but also among the students, and not just between the faculty and the students, but among the students themselves. So what's really interesting to me is that the students are extremely supportive of each other, even with students who are not from their group, even with students that they don't socialize with on a regular basis. I find that, you know, yeah, we kind of work together as a team on every level. So I like that. I like the feeling that I have coming to work every day. Overwhelmingly positive. That's all I can say.
What can British Management University offer to future students that is different than other universities in Uzbekistan?
British Management University is very interesting because we have partnerships with two universities, and these partnerships are very strong. So we have a partnership in the foundation year, which is the first year of studies. We have a partnership with the University of Reading, which is very famous in the UK. Everybody knows it. I won't say much about that, but yes, once you complete the foundation year, you receive a certificate from the University of Reading. So this enables you to then apply to other universities, or you can continue with us and you still have this certificate that's been issued from the University of Reading, which is great. I think BMU also is unique in that it's very student-centered in terms of support. So we have a lot of academic support available to students. We have a writing center. We have a learning resource center. We have regular conversation groups that meet for English immersion. We have sort of academic discussion groups that we provide to the students. And, you know, students who are struggling, we notice. We take notice and we try to take action before it becomes something that can damage their record or, you know, their prospects.
As we know, you are focusing on motivating university students and faculty in Uzbekistan regarding their international goals. And what inspired you to take action or go deep in this?
You know, I've benefited so much from international education opportunities and from working internationally. And I don't feel that my role in life is to force that on other people, but I do think that my role in life is to make sure that they feel they can access it. Yeah. I just would like very much for everyone to understand what it feels like to have access to an international education, and especially for business students. I mean, it's almost impossible to do business in a vacuum, right? Or on a small scale anymore. Even the smallest, business ends up somehow being affected by this sort of global market and by the way that we move things now, by, you know, online marketing and so on and so forth. So everything is kind of existing in multiple worlds now. And I feel like we don't really have the option to be limited in our perspective anymore. So I want to make sure that all my students feel like they have access to the world and to the global marketplace and to the ideas that they're curious about and to the opportunities that they've been dreaming about. That's really important to me. That's why, in a nutshell.
Thank you so much for this interesting interview. And I hope all viewers got answers for their questions. Thank you, our subscribers, for watching this video. Don't forget to subscribe our BMU channel and comment below which interview you would like to see next time.